Hello, my friend. You're listening to the Sort Yourself Out podcast. And this week, we're discussing the ideas and energies that are fueling and creating your life. I'm your host, Janine Hunt, natural health therapist for over 30 years, hypnotherapist, lifelong student, and spiritual seeker. I like to seek out the most effective practices and techniques that provide the greatest bang for my buck and the fastest route to freedom from whatever is holding us back. I can't wait to share with you these powerful techniques so that you too can sort yourself out, know deeper meaning in your life, and best of all, a sense of inner peace. So let's get started. Hello there. Thank you so much for joining me today. We're going to be looking at a very basic aspect of creation. Basically, of how you are creating the events and circumstances of your life. Because you know you create your reality, right? How do you do that? Well, it's according to the dominant thoughts and emotions that you continually energize. Listen to this quote from Education in the New Age by Alice Bailey. Events, circumstances, happenings, and physical phenomena of every kind are simply symbols of what is occurring in the inner worlds. Now that means that you are bringing into manifestation the things that you are focusing on mentally and emotionally. So if what you're experiencing in your life is not to your taste, maybe you've got some mental housework to do. And that's what we're discussing today. Now, there are two ways in which thought can be used: the creative and the uncreative. Now, the creative is where you consciously take charge of your thoughts. You use your intention to create what you want to experience in your life. And you continually, yes, continually and consistently and more or less incessantly monitor your thoughts and your state of mind so that you are energizing only those thoughts and ideas and visions which serve your intentions. The uncreative aspect, which is what the majority of people do, is creating by default. And this is accepting the prevailing ideas of mass thinking and accepting the ideas that we've been conditioned with as children. These are the ideas about life and the nature of existence that we learned in our families as little kids. We also picked up all sorts of ideas from society and from relatives and teachers and other kids and TV. So that is the uncreative way. So being a conscious creator involves consciously choosing again and again to release the old, outworn ideas that do not serve us, that may have been passed down from generation to generation. And they might be based on what life was like a century ago. And to choose only what furthers our goals, desires, and intentions. So I want to illustrate this by letting you in on why I named my website and my business the Inspiration Cloud. So you know that modern idea of the cloud, that cyberspace where information is stored. You know, you can upload all of your photos and documents and stuff and keep it stored safely there. Well, I like that idea of creating a site where inspiring and illuminating and uplifting ideas and resources are stored. So this is my Inspiration Cloud. But I also got the cloud idea from a mysterious and intriguing concept that I found in the Ageless Wisdom teachings that really captured my imagination. And that is the rain cloud of knowable things. Isn't that amazing? The rain cloud of knowable things. Oh, I just love that. It gives me shivers. This rain cloud is essentially a reservoir on the mental plane of the impending, overshadowing, and revelatory storehouse of energy, which is ready to emerge in human consciousness as the recognition of that which is new and better and progressively right, as Alice Bailey described it. Now, this is based on another concept, which you may have heard of, that everything in the universe already exists. There is not a single idea which does not already exist in the universal mind. There cannot be things that exist outside of all that is. Now, as humans, we can penetrate into this rain cloud of knowable things and contact these new ideas that are ripe for emergence in the world for the betterment of all life. Now, isn't that a lovely, inspiring concept? So for me, the inspiration cloud is my own little revelatory reservoir of ideas that intrigue and inspire me, and that I hope will be inspiring to you too. Now, in thinking about the inner energies and ideas that are manifesting your outer material existence, I want you to imagine that you have your own personal cloud. And I want you to consider what you are putting into your cloud. I'm not talking photos. Are you putting in, aka, energizing thoughts and ideas that will nourish what you intend to create? Or are you operating by default on your own programming unconsciously? So are you using the creative or the uncreative method? Here's a phrase to consider, borrowed from computer coding. Garbage in, garbage out. If you upload garbagey thoughts to your cloud, you'll get garbagey results manifesting in your life. And we don't want that, do we? Because energy follows and conforms itself to thought. So if you've got some worry that you're festering over and you're nourishing and feeding and fueling it all day long every day, as you fret and ruminate on it, you are pouring energy into what you do not want. But happily, when we understand this, we illumine both the cause and the cure of human problems. So do you get the importance of that? These energies are both the cause and cure of human problems. And that applies to you personally in your own life, as well as to the human family and our mass creative potential. So you are in the driving seat here. And I am inviting you to put joy and beauty and abundance and all the good things that will energize your intentions and goals into your cloud. Do not fill your personal cloud space up with the crap you do not want. Pour your energies and focus into what you want. And here is a really good way to know whether you are energizing what you want. So note that when you are feeling bad, you are filling your cloud with crap you do not want and ultimately inhibiting the manifestation of your intentions. So pay attention to your feelings, and that will help you to know more about your state of mind and your thoughts. So don't beat yourself up about it, but use that bad feeling as a signal to recalibrate and to switch from default unconscious creation mode to conscious creation mode. Make your cloud the repository of all the good, inspiring things that you want for your life and also what you want for the good of the world. Now, I'm not getting into the how-to today, other than to point you to some of my earlier episodes that cover all of this good stuff and to offer you a couple of amazing free goodies that will help you to be a conscious creator. Firstly, we have my Life Conspires to Make Me Successful affirmations. This free audio download will help you to prepare the right mindset to create and attract what you want in your life so that you're not using the tired old beliefs that have got you where you are. These inspiring affirmations instill the belief that things are stacked in your favor and that you are attracting inspiration, opportunities, and miracles. And also that you do not need to rely on your individual resources alone when you open yourself to the support of life itself. So I'll put a link to this in the show notes, and you can also get it at theinspirationcloud.com/SYO38, and those are the numerals 38. Next, to help you consciously put exactly what you want into your cloud of wonderful intentions, we have my free Visualization Essentials Guide. Visualization is the creative force behind every single thing that has ever manifested on the physical plane. So I suggest that you spend a few minutes morning and night actively visualizing what you want to manifest in various areas of your life, like relationships, career, home life, finances, health. My Visualization Essentials Guide teaches you how to visualize successfully so that you can consciously take charge of your life and harness the creative forces of the universe to create what you want in your life. Again, you can get that guide at theinspirationcloud.com/SYO38, and there's a link in the show notes. Okay, here are some other podcast episodes to check out where you'll find lots of information relating to everything we've been discussing today about how to manage your mind and your thoughts and your ideas so that you can be a conscious creator and fill your cloud with all the good stuff. So, number one, the first episode is actually episode number 3, called The 3 Phases of Transformation and How to Activate Them in Your Life. Next, episode number 5, How to Program Your Mind to Get the Life You Want. Number 28, How to Silence Your Inner Critic, because that has a lot to do with what's going on in your mind, okay? All those thoughts that are popping up and putting all sorts of crap into your cloud. Number 31, how to get unstuck and break through to success and well-being. Number 27, how to accelerate your personal and spiritual growth. So in all of these episodes, you're going to find a lot on managing your mind and your mindset and your attitudes and your feelings. And if you are interested in learning more deeply about all of these fascinating topics and practices to take you further on your spiritual path and to amplify your well-being and your positive impact in the world, why don't you sign up to the waitlist for my upcoming Inner Circle membership? Go on over to theinspirationcloud.com/membership to get on the waitlist, and I'll keep you in the loop. Okay, my friend, that is all for today. I hope you found today's discussion illuminating and that you're going to pay much more attention to what you're putting into your own personal cloud. So thanks so much for spending your time with me. It's a lovely thing to know that you've been doing that, and I really do appreciate it. So take care, be well, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Thanks so much for listening to the podcast. I really hope you found it helpful and full of uplifting ideas that you can put into practice in your life. And if you have, chances are your friends and family will too. So please share it with them on social media. You'll be helping them to sort themselves out, because I bet you think they need it, right? But seriously, you'll also be doing me a huge favor, and I will be eternally grateful for your generosity. It would also be lovely if you would leave me a review on iTunes, preferably a nice one, please. And don't forget to subscribe to the podcast while you're there. If you have any questions or would like me to address a certain topic, I'd love to hear from you. You can email me at info@theinspirationcloud.com. Have a good one, folks. Thanks again, and I'll see you next week.